In our last class, we have learned about JavaScript for loop. So inside this class, we are going to discuss about JavaScript nested loop. So all of them are loop methods. So inside this class, we are going to discuss about nested loop method. So we are going to save us this file for creating a separate file. I'm just giving the name nested loop.html. We can save this. Now you can see we have a loop here, so I'm just going to use this, save this, open in browser. So you can see we have thousands of time, just this message. I'm just going to decrease that to the 5 times. We can just save this and refresh. So you can see the starting point should be 1. We can save and refresh. Now we have message till the 5. So nested loop is called if you are using a loop inside another loop. So this will be a nested loop. So we have already discussed about nested if. If we are using if inside another if, so that will be nested if. But if you are using a loop inside another loop, so that will be nested loop. So it is very simple. You can just copy this whole section, Control C, and you can paste inside this parentheses or curly braces after this document.write. We can paste this here. So I'm just going to change the message. For example, I'm just saying here first loop. So I want to just make the first loop bold. So I'm just writing here this inside the b tick, b close. And this is the second loop. I'm just writing here second loop. I want to just make the second loop italic inside the itick. So you can just use here or use here itick close. We can save this. Now come here and refresh. So you can see first loop and second loop. So you can see the text is italic. So just focus on the condition. Inside the first loop, we have told here the starting point is 1, then it is less than 5. So you can see first loop message here. So let me copy this one more time. For example, this loop is just started from here till here. I can copy this and I can paste this after this one, after this document.write inside this one. So I can paste this here. I can just say third loop. So this should be bold. And here also we are using bold method. So one more time, we can copy this like this. We can just work in better way and you will be understand. Just I'm going to make you understand through this. We can save this. Now come here and refresh. So first loop, second loop, third loop. So you can see again we have third loop and third loop here. So this should be fourth. And you can just save this. Now come here and refresh. So first we have this first loop, then you have this inside this one, then you have third loop, then you have this one. The third loop is inside the second loop and the fourth loop is inside the third loop. Then we have 1 time, 2 time, 3 time, 4 time, 5 time. Because the statement is just 1 till 5. The starting point is 1 and the ending point is 5. So you can just focus here. So we have just 1 time, 2 time, 3 time, 4 time, 5 times. So you have just the correct result. And this is the first loop. We have the second loop inside the first one. We have the third loop inside the second one. And the fourth one is inside the third loop. The same process that we have here. This is the first loop. So you can see this is the second, this is the third, this is the fourth loop. So everything is just very easy. If you are following the rule, you are following the steps. So I hope you are understand how you can create for loop inside JavaScript. So thank you for watching this video and see you in the next class.